brothers and sisters, to increase your iman. Read the miracle, recite the Qur'an. Recite it every day and do read it loud. The verses of Qur'an are all Muslims' pride. This miracle was revealed over a long time span, sent from Allah to an angel, then to a man. That man was Muhammad, the best of creation.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. All praises to Allah alone. We praise Him and we seek His help. Whomsoever Allah guides is the truly guided one, and whomsoever Allah leaves aside, none can show him guidance. May the best peace and blessing be upon Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. Our dear viewers, welcome to another live edition of our program, Correct Your Recitation. And I would like to welcome our studio guests as well. Thank you for joining us. Jazakumullahu khairan. Thank you, all of you. Without any further ado, inshallah, today we'll begin the second edition in Surat Ghafir, chapter number 40, the Makki Surah, as we agreed last episode. And today we're going to recite from the beginning as well, even though we did recite its beginning last episode. But when it comes to the explanation, it will be from ayah number 5. So I'd like to listen to Surat Ghafir again from its beginning between Sheikh Abdul Khaliq and Sheikh Abdul Rahman. Sheikh Abdul Khaliq, please proceed on.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم حاميم تنزيل الكتاب من الله العزيز العليم غافر الذنب وقابل التوب شديد العقاب ذي القول لا إله إلا هو لا فلا يغرك تقلبهم في البلاد ما يجادل في آيات الله إلا الذين كفروا فلا يغرك تقلبهم في البلاد كذبت قبلهم قوم نوح والأحزاب من بعدهم وهمت كل أمة برسولهم ليأخذوه وجادلوا بالباطل ليدحضوا به الحق فأخذتهم فكيف كان عقاب وكذلك حقت كلمة ربك على الذين كفروا أنهم أصحاب النار
الذين يحملون العرش ومن حوله يسبحون بحمد ربهم يسبحون بحمد ربهم ويؤمنون به ويستغفرون للذين آمنوا ربنا وسعت كل شيء رحمة وعلما فاغفر للذين تابوا واتبعوا سبيلك وقهم عذاب الجحيم. ربنا وأدخلهم جنات عدن التي وعدتهم ومن صلح من آبائهم وأزواجهم وذرياتهم إنك أنت العزيز الحكيم. وقهم السيئات ومن تق السيئات يومئذ فقد رحمته وذلك هو الفوز العظيم.
الله, how beautiful, mashallah. Thank you, both of you. May Allah bless you abundantly. MashaAllah. Brothers and sisters, as we said in the last episode, Surat Ghafir is the first of these seven chapters which are known as Alu Hamim, as Ibn Sirin dislikes to call them Hawamim. And we spoke about the meaning of Ghafir al-Dhanb, Qabil al-Tawb, Shadid al-Iqab, Dhittawul, etc. Then we came to Ayah 4 and we learned that those who argue concerning the proofs, the evidences, the verses, and the ayat of Allah are only the disbelievers. So, O Muhammad, let not their enjoyment, their prosperity in the life of this world deceive you. And Allah is not only addressing Prophet Muhammad, He is addressing all the believers. Just be patient. سَنَسْتَدِرِجُهُمْ مِنْ حَيْثُ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ وَأُمْلِي لَهُمْ إِنَّ كَيْدِي مَتِينَ. It's a matter of giving them respite, but their fate will be the same, similar to the fate of the non-believing people in the nations before us. For every prophet, he had a few followers, but the vast majority of people, وَلَا تَجِدُ أَكْثَرَهُمْ شَاكِرِينَ. And on the other hand, he said, وَقَلِيلٌ مِّنْ عِبَادِيَ الشَّكُورُ. So the fate of the believers is known. And also those who oppose the truth and challenge it, Allah the Almighty ruined them and destroyed them in this life, in addition to the awaiting torment on the hereafter. So here, brothers and sisters, Allah the Almighty says in ayah number 5, كَذَّبَتْ قَبْلَهُمْ قَوْمُ نُوحٍ وَالْأَحْزَابُ مِنْ بَعْدِهِمْ. Wait a minute. The pronoun of قَبْلَهُمْ, يعني before them, there were other nations who belied the message of their messengers, such as the people of Prophet Nuh, peace be upon him. The pronoun قَبْلَهُمْ, before them, them refers to whom? Allah was still addressing Prophet Muhammad. So he is telling them before the Meccan pagans. They were tyrant nations. They were powerful people. And they belied their prophets. and they denied the messengers, such as the people of Nuh, وَالْأَحْزَابُ مِنْ بَعْدِهِمْ, and also the confederates after them. They also belied their messengers, whether the people of Prophet Moses and Aaron, whether the people who were supposed to follow Prophet Jesus, or Zachary, or Jonah, they all belied their prophets. And then what happened? هَمَّتْ كُلُّ أُمَّةٍ بِرَسُولِهِمْ لِيَأْخُذُوا. Every nation, the disbelievers among them, they plotted against their messenger to seize him. Didn't they do that with Prophet Abraham? Yeah. They almost did. Okay? They built a huge fire and they actually cast them in the midst of it. We find in Surat Al-Imran, the Almighty Allah says, وَمَا مُحَمَّدٌ إِلَّا رَسُولٌ قَدْ خَلَتْ مِنْ قَبْلِهِ الرُّسُلُ. Muhammad is just a messenger whom many messengers before him have come. And they're gone. They're dead now. Then he says to the believers about Muhammad, أَفَإِن مَاتَ أَوْ قُتِلَ. What? Could a messenger get killed? Could the enemies of Allah get a chance to kill the messenger of Allah? That happens. And he said to the believers, whether Muhammad is dead, natural death, or even got killed, are you going to abandon your faith and go back on your heels? No, you shouldn't. Because he delivered the message, so resume spreading that message and calling people unto it. And some prophets were actually killed. They killed Prophet Yahya, the son of Prophet Zachary. And Prophet Zachary was about to get killed and he had to hide from them. Allah split open a tree and he entered it to hide from them. And Allah the Almighty said about Banu Israel, the children of Israel, that they have killed many of their prophets. أَفَكُلَّمَا جَاءَكُمْ رَسُولٌ بِمَا لَا تَهْوَى أَنفُسُكُمْ فَفَرِيقًا كَذَّبْتُمْ وَفَرِيقًا تَقْتُلُونَ. They have killed, they have assassinated many of their prophets. And they have attempted to do the same with Prophet Muhammad. When the Jews of Banu Nadir plotted twice to kill the Prophet ﷺ, then Khaybar, they poisoned the food to kill Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That is their tradition. So Allah the Almighty says that hammat kullu ummatin bi rasulihim liyakhudhu. The disbelievers in every nation, they try their utmost to seize the Prophet, to kill him. They tried to do with the Prophet Salih after they killed the she camel. Correct? So they said, وَجَادَلُوا بِالْبَاطِلِ لِيُدْحِضُوا بِهِ الْحَقِّ. And they argued and disputed by means of falsehood. Why? To refute therewith the truth. And Allah the Almighty says, وَقُلْ جَاءَ الْحَقُّ وَزَهَقَ الْبَاطِلِ إِنَّ الْبَاطِلَ كَانَ زَهُوقًا. The truth will always and most definitely prevail. So your effort is always in vain. This is the bottom line. No matter how much you plot to seize the Prophet or the messenger, or the successors of the messengers, or the preachers who are carrying the message of the prophets, the message will spread. And Allah will not leave a single house, a single home, whether constructed of mud, or steel, or concrete, but this religion will enter it, whether you like it or not. فَأَخَذْتُهُمْ. As they plotted to seize the Prophet, and they thought that they can block the sun so that people will not see the truth, I seize them. فَكَيْفَ كَانَ عِقَابٌ. So look, I seize them with my punishment, and how terrible was my punishment. You read in the Qur'an, as for the Pharaoh and his people, أَنَّارُ يُعْرَضُونَ عَلَيْهَا غُدُوًا وَعَشِيًّا. And this ayah is also of Surah Ghafir. Yes. We'll come across this ayah, inshallah. أغرقناهم. Allah drowned the Pharaoh and his host, and that was not the end of it. That was just the beginning of the chastisement, the punishment. The people of Nuh, أغرقوا فأدخلوا نارا. They were drowned, and soon after they were admitted into hellfire. The people of Prophet Hud, أرسلنا عليهم, the wind which he, the violent one, you call it hurricane, you call it tornado, سبع ليال وثمانية أيام حسوما فترى القوم فيها صرعا كأنهم أعجاز نخل خاوية فهل ترى لهم من باقية. So he sent the violent one, which lasted for 7 nights and 8 days. It eliminated them. Afterward, you could see, normally, like in the States, whenever there is a hurricane, it lasts for a day or two, a couple days, but 7 nights, 8 days consecutively, it utterly destroyed them. So afterward, you see them like empty trunks of dead palm trees. Subhanallah. The people of Salah, they were struck with the shock and awe. Huge scream, it caused them all to die, and so on and so forth. فَكَيْفَ كَانَ عِقَابٌ. Then in the following ayah, the Almighty Allah says, وَكَذَلِكَ حَقَّتْ كَلِمَةُ رَبِّكَ عَلَى الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا أَنَّهُمْ أَصْحَابُ النَّارِ. Thus has the word of your Lord been justified against the disbelievers, that they deserve to be the dwellers of fire. Why? In Surah Al-Isra, the Almighty Allah says, وَمَا كُنَّا مُعَذِّبِينَ حَتَّى نَبْعَثَ رَسُولًا. Allah was not going to punish anyone without showing him or her or them the truth. If they accepted, they're saved. If they insist on challenging the truth and hindering people from the path of Allah, then they are worthy of his punishment. So the word of punishment is due and justified against the disbelievers, and they will become among the dwellers of fire because of what? They received the message. He didn't send any people to punishment without receiving the message and without making it very clear and obvious to them. But they rejected the truth. We find a similar reference in Surah Az-Zariyat. After Allah spoke about previous nations, and He mentioned the fate of the people who belied Prophet Nuh, Prophet Abraham, Prophet Moses, Isa, and so on. He mentioned Prophet Moses, and he mentioned other prophets who done salih. He wasn't mentioned Prophet Jesus, peace be upon him. Then he said, كَذَلِكَ مَا أَتَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِهِمْ مِنْ رَسُولٍ إِلَّا قَالُوا سَاحِرٌ أَوْ مَجْنُونٌ أَتَوَاصَوْا بِهِ بَلْ هُمْ قَوْمٌ طَاغُونَ. Allah was, you know, condoling, entertaining, and assuring Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, that look, here is all the prophets before you, and this is what happened with them. مَا أَتَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِهِمْ مِنْ رَسُولٍ إِلَّا قَالُوا سَاحِرٌ أَوْ مَجْنُونَ. All people oppose their prophets. Vast majority of nations oppose their prophets. أَتَوَاصَوْا بِهِ. They claim that the messenger is insane, is a sorcerer. And subhanAllah, the same misconceptions are being repeated over and over and over. Like all those different nations read from the same book. So they deserve, the Meccan pagans, they deserve to face the same fate. Then we're finished with the ayat that Sheikh Abdul Khaliq recited. And Abdul Rahman chose to recite the beautiful glad tidings. الَّذِينَ يَحْمِلُونَ الْعَرْشَ وَمَنْ حَوْلَهُ. Who bears the throne of Allah? The angels. Allah created angels to bear the throne of Allah. And the throne of Allah is the greatest creation at large. And inshallah, when you guys, inshallah, may Allah make it easy for us to enter paradise. And even the highest place in paradise, Al-Firdaus Al-A'la, the rooftop will be the Arsh. The ceiling of paradise of Al-Firdaus Al-A'la will be Arsh al-Rahman. Subhanallah. So those angels who are either bearing the throne or circulating around the throne, يُسَبِّحُونَ بِحَمْدِ رَبِّهِمْ. They are constantly, 24-7, non-stop. They don't get bored. They do what? They glorify the praise of their Lord. And they say, praise be to you. You're the most free from any imperfection. That is the meaning of tasbih. At-tanzihu an al-naqas. You're definitely free from any imperfection. And how can any imperfection come to you while you are the creator of every perfect creation? So they glorify the praise of the Lord. وَيُؤْمِنُونَ بِهِ And eventually they believe in Him. And here is the glad tidings, brothers and sisters. We're not alone. Those few of the creation of Allah, you're not alone. The believers. The angels are also constantly making dua for you. What do they say? يَسْتَغْفِرُونَ لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا They constantly seek forgiveness for the believers. Allahu Akbar. And they say among their invocation and the way of glorifying and praising the Lord, رَبَّنَا وَسِعْتَ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ رَحْمَةً وَعِلْمًا They teach us how to make dua. Begin your invocation by glorifying and praising the Almighty Allah, then present your need. So they say, Our Lord, you comprehend all things in mercy and knowledge. So, now present your need. فَغْفِرْ لِلَّذِينَ تَابُوا وَاتَّبَعُوا سَبِيلَكَ وَقِيهِمْ عَذَابَ الْجَحِيمِ So forgive those who repent and follow your path and save them from the torment of the blazing fire. Imagine we're not alone. The angels are constantly making dua for the believers. This is one of the virtues of belief that you have the angels invoke Allah to have mercy on you. Where do you find a similar ayah in the Qur'an? وَسِعْتَ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ رَحْمَةً وَعِلْمًا In which surah? Surah Al-A'raf. When Musa alayhi salam invoked Allah and he said, إِنَّا هُدِنَا إِلَيْكَ يعني وَيْتُبْنَا إِلَيْكَ What did he say? So Allah the Almighty said, وَرَحْمَتِي وَسِعَتْ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ My mercy have encompassed everything. Here the angels are praising Allah through one of His qualities, which is not just being merciful. No, His mercy encompasses everything. What does it mean, encompasses everything? In the hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِنَّ لِلَّهِ The mercy of the Almighty Allah is 100 parts. He saved with him 99 parts of his mercy so that he would accept the intercessions and would have mercy on the believers on the day of judgment, forgive sins, pardon sins, and admit people into paradise. And all the mercy that we're enjoying in our worldly life is only one part out of 100 parts of his mercy. Mm-hmm. And out of this mercy, fine wild beasts, they take care of their babies. Even though they are wild, but they know that they love their babies, they take care of their babies. So this mercy, even in the hearts of the wild beast, is a segment of this 1% of Allah's mercy, which He sent down on earth. And the 99% of His mercy is saved. Why? So on the day of judgment, once you believe in Allah, even though you're full of shortcomings and you're loaded with sins, you will be eligible for His mercy. He said, فَسَأَكْتُبُهَا لِلَّذِينَ يَتَّقُونَ I shall ordain my mercy for whom? For the righteous people. Those who shall follow the messenger, the prophet, the illiterate, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, whose mention was brought up in the Torah and in the Gospel. Great. وَاتَّبَعُوا سَبِيلَكَ وَقِيهِمْ عَذَابَ الْجَحِيمِ And have mercy on them and protect them against the torment of the blazing fire. Another dua, رَبَّنَا وَأَدْخِلْهُمْ جَنَّاتِ عَدْنٍ الَّتِي وَعَدْتَهُمْ Oh Allah, admit them into the gardens of Eden, the gardens of paradise, which you promised them. Only them? No. وَمَنْ صَلَحَ مِنْ آبَائِهِمْ وَأَزْوَاجِهِمْ وَذُرِّيَّتِهِمْ That is the best of the best, to have your loved ones with you in paradise, to have your parents, your spouses, and your offspring, that is like, peace of mind, cool for one's eyes, to have his family members with him in Jannah. That is the supplication of the angels for us. إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ الْعَزِيزُ الْحَكِيمُ Learn, brothers and sisters. You want to make dua? Begin your supplication by praising Allah, and conclude by praising Allah. وَقِيهِمُ السَّيِّئَاتِ السيئات is plural of Sayyi'ah. And a sayyi'ah is any bad deed, minor or major. Qihim, يعني protect them against a sayyi'ah. I find it very strange that most of us, when we make dua, we ask Allah for sitr or satr, which is to conceal our faults. While there is even a superior level of satr, which is to put a veil to protect us against indulging into a sayyi'at. That is the kind of satr which is even superior. قِهِمُ السَّيِّئَاتِ يعني protect them against falling into sins, subhanallah. Protect them and save them against the punishment which is caused because of erring or sinning. And whomsoever you save from the punishment. وَمَنْ تَقِ السَّيِّئَاتِ يَوْمَئِذٍ فَقَدْ رَحِمْتَهُ Whomsoever you save from your torment on that day, indeed, you have mercy on him. May Allah have mercy on us and protect us against his punishment, both in this life and in the hereafter. And whoever will attain that, brothers and sisters, has indeed attained the ultimate success. وَذَلِكَ هُوَ الْفَوْزُ الْعَظِيمُ And that is indeed the ultimate success. May the Almighty Allah grant us all this ultimate success. Allahumma inna nas'aluka al-firdaws al-a'la min al-jannah. We'll take a short break and inshallah we'll be back in a few minutes. So that will open the phone lines for those who will be interested in reciting those beautiful ayat with us. Please stay tuned.
Recite it every day and do read it loud.
Of category is one of the seven people who will be under the shade when there is no shade but Allah's shade on the Day of Judgment.
Colors of Arabic language, explain the word, the meaning of the word haya. They said it's the fear of something that's shameful.
At the same time you try to solve your problems, then you will see the results. And the advantage is sticking to the sunnah. When you stick to the sunnah, that's when you see the advantage. But could you elaborate more? What do you mean, sticking to the sunnah?
It made a lot of, major sins, because the problem is that they convince you, they try to convince you by saying, Wallahi is the best, Wallahi, it is the best. You won't find anything like it, So you're going from a sin to another sin, to a greater sin.
Man, it's been over 1 hour, I'm waiting for you.
Okay, bro, it's not a big deal.
At least you should have called.
Oh, not again. Don't get too serious.
عباد الرحمن الذين يمشون على الأرض هونا وإذا خاطبهم الجاهلون قالوا سلاما.
So let's get inspired. Let's get motivated to worship Allah in the best way. Let's get motivated not only to worship Allah in the best way, but to race to do good deeds. Join us in this program, Islamic Motivation, by your brother, Rayyan Arab, exclusively on Huda TV.
أفلا يتدبرون القرآن ولو كان من عند غير الله لوجدوا فيه اختلافا كثيرا.
We all know that a person's iman increases and decreases, and the best way to increase your iman is through the Quran.
To contemplate, to reflect, to ponder over the verses of the Quran.
أَفَلَا يَتَدَبَّرُونَ الْقُرْآنَ وَلَوْ كَانَ مِنْ عِنْدِ غَيْرِ اللَّهِ لَوَجَدُوا فِيهِ اخْتِلَافًا كَثِيرًا.
In this program, we will listen to the Quran first, and that should soften our hearts. And then once we get to know the meanings and contemplate over these meanings, then we can change by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
وَلَا يَأْتُونَكَ بِمَثَلٍ إِلَّا جِئْنَاكَ بِالْحَقِّ وَأَحْسَنَ تَفْسِيرًا ولا يأتونك بمثل إلا جئناك بالحق وأحسن تفسيرا.
Join us on Quran Circle 2 and increase your iman.
I spend my life running away from you. Now I have nowhere to turn except to you.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He created man. And man has outer features as well as inner features. One of the most important of his inner features is his heart. So what is the heart? What is meant by this heart that is in our bodies? And what is the health of the heart? And what is the disease of the heart? There are many diseases of the heart, and there are many actions of the heart, things that make it healthy. So what are these diseases? What are these actions? Come and join us on Huda TV in this program of ours, Heart Therapy.
So drink my heart, please, wash the filth away. Don't leave me drowning here, alone and astray. Don't leave me drowning here, alone and astray.
Recite it every day and do read it loud.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, and welcome back. I would like to remind you with our phone numbers in case that anyone wants to give us a call. Today we'll be reciting from the beginning of Surah Ghafir through ayah number 9, inshallah. And our phone numbers are area code 002, then 02385551, area code 002, then 01005469323. And the two WhatsApp numbers, air code 001-361-489-1503, air code 001-347-80625. Won't be able to take any messages, obviously, only calls for this episode, inshallah. Meanwhile, we'll begin with our studio guest, Mahmoud, to recite from the beginning of Surah Ghafir through ayah number 9. Please.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم حاميم تنزيل الكتاب من الله العزيز العليم غافر الذنب وقابل التوب شديد العقاب ذي الطول لا إله إلا هو إليه المصير ما يجادل في آيات الله إلا الذين كفروا فلا يغرك تقلبهم في البلاد كذبت قبلهم قوم نوح والأحزاب من بعدهم وهمت كل أمة برسولهم ليأخذوه وجادلوا بالباطل ليدحضوا به الحق فأخذتهم فكيف كان عقاب وكذلك حقت كلمة ربك على الذين كفروا أنهم أصحاب النار.
Sister Umm Ni'ma from Australia. Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Welcome to the program, Sister Umm Ni'ma. And today we're reading from Surah Ghafir. Would you like to begin from the first ayah?
Okay, Ghafir, and can you please tell me the page, please?
Okay, 467, chapter number 40.
467,
okay.
Inshallah.
Yeah, go ahead.
Yeah, okay. I'm still up opening the Mus'haf.
It's okay, take your time. But it all depends on which copy do you have, because I'm giving you the...
Okay, yeah, I found it.
Okay, go ahead.
467.
Yes.
Okay. I begin from
yes.
Begin.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم حاميم.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. حاميم. تنزيل الكتاب من الله العزيز العليم. غافر الذنب وقابل التوب شديد العقاب ذي الطول لا إله إلا هو إليه المصير ما يجادل في آيات الله إلا الذين كفروا فلا يغررك تقلبهم في البلاد كذبت قبلهم قوم نوح والأحزاب من بعدهم وهمت كل أمة برسولهم ليأخذوه وجادلوا بالباطل.
I want you to slow down, sister Umm Ni'ma. Go ahead and recite this ayah from the beginning. كذبت قبلهم قوم نوح.
كذبت قبلهم قوم نوح. قوم نوح والأحزاب من بعدهم وهمت كل أمة برسولهم ليأخذوه وجادلوا بالباطل ليدحدوا به الحق فأخذتهم فكيف كان عقاب وكذلك حقت كلمة ربك على الذين كفروا أنهم أصحاب النار الذين يحملون العرش ومن حوله يسبحون بحمد ربهم ويؤمنون به ويستغفرون للذين آمنوا ربنا وسعت كل شيء رحمة وعلما فاغفر للذين تابوا واتبعوا سبيلك وقهم عذاب الجحيم وربنا وأدخلهم جنات عدن التي وعدتهم ومن صلح من آبائهم وأزواجهم وذرياتهم إنك أنت العزيز الحكيم وقهم السيئات ومن تق السيئات يومئذ فقد رحمته وذلك هو الفوز العظيم.
حسبك ما شاء الله. حسبك أم نعمة ما شاء الله. بارك الله فيك. رمضان السلام عليكم.
وعليكم السلام.
Go ahead and recite from the beginning, please. حاميم سورة غافر. Yes, could you go ahead and recite from the beginning of Surat Ghafir? Hameem. Okay, if we're having bad connection, we can skip this call and try again. Okay. Adnan, brother Adnan. Adnan from Ethiopia. Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum salam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
How are you, Adnan?
Wa alaikum salam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Go ahead and recite from the beginning.
Fine, alhamdulillah. Okay, from the beginning?
Yes.
Okay. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم آمين تنزيل الكتاب من الله العزيز العليم غافر الذنب وقابل التوب شديد التوب لا إله إلا هو إليه المصير في آيات الله الذين كفروا فلا يغرك تقلبهم في البلاد وكذلك
طيب
في البلاد كذبت قبل
Adnan, I want you to listen to me just for a few seconds. We have some letters where you must stick your tongue out when you pronounce them. Those letters are three. Zal, Tha, and Dha. Zal, to distinguish it from the Zai. So when you say, Kathalika, Kathalika, look at the tip of my tongue, Kathalika, Kathalika. And when you want to pronounce it by itself, you say, Az, Az, Az. Otherwise, if you keep your tongue inside, it sounds like Azai, and that's another letter, Az. Okay, so you don't say kazalika because there is no word in Arabic kazalika. Rather, there is wakazalika, wakazalika.
Okay?
I hope you're gonna say the same kazabat, kazabat. So every time you see that letter, which is similar to dal but with a dot on top, you stick the tip of your tongue out. You say az, az. Okay, go ahead.
Okay. A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. كذبت قبلهم قوم نوح والأحزاب من بعدهم وحمت كل أمة برسولهم ليأخذوه وجادلوا بالباطل ليدهدوا به الحق فأخذتهم فكيف كان عقاب وكذلك حقت كلمة ربك على الذين كفروا أنهم أصحاب النار الذين يحملون العرش ومن حوله يسبحون بحمد ربهم ويؤمنون به ويستغفرون للذين آمنوا ربنا وسعت كل شيء رحمة وعلما فاغفر للذين تابوا واتبعوا سبيلك وقهم عذاب الجحيم
حسبك Adnan. Just you need to practice today how to pronounce the letter ha. Okay? If you manage to pronounce it correctly and know its articulation point, It comes from the throat, like the ha, but there is a gap between them. There is a space. So we have to distinguish between the ha and the ha. We don't say nahnu. We say nahnu. Nahnu. Okay? So you need to practice the ha and you will be great, mashallah. I'm really, really happy, mashallah, you're reciting that good and great, but we need to practice the letter ha. The beginning, ha mim, not ha mim. حاميم okay. رحمة أصحاب السلام عليكم ورحمة الله Brother عبد الكريم from Kuwait السلام عليكم يا عبد الكريم
وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله وبركاته
أخي welcome to the program go ahead and recite from Ayah 7 الذين يحملون العرش
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الذين يحملون العرش ومن حوله يسبحون بحمد ربهم ويؤمنون به ويستغفرون للذين آمنوا ربنا وسعت كل شيء رحمة وعلما فاغفر للذين تابوا واتبعوا سبيلك وقهم عذاب الجحيم ربنا وأدخلهم جنات عدن التي وعدتهم ومن صلح من آبائهم وأزواجهم وذرياتهم إنك أنت العزيز الحكيم وقهم السيئات ومن تق السيئات يومئذ فقد رحمته وذلك هو الفوز العظيم.
حسبك بارك الله فيك. I'd like to wrap it up by listening to your recitation عزت and again from ayah 7 الذين يحملون العرش.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم الذين يحملون العرش ومن حوله يسبحون بحمد ربهم ويؤمنون به ويستغفرون للذين آمنوا ربنا وسعت كل شيء رحمة وعلما فاغفر للذين تابوا واتبعوا سبيلك وقهم عذاب الجحيم ربنا وأدخلهم جنات عدن التي وعدتهم ومن صلح من آبائهم وأزواجهم وذرياتهم إنك أنت العزيز الحكيم وقهم السيئات ومن تق السيئات يومئذ فقد رحمته وذلك هو الفوز العظيم.
Our program, correct to recitation, and until next week, I leave you all in the care of Allah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Brothers and sisters, to increase your iman, read the miracle, recite the Quran. Recite it every day and do read it loud. The verses of Quran are all Muslims' pride. This miracle was revealed over a long time span, sent from Allah to an angel, then to a man. That man was Muhammad, the best of creation. We were chosen to be part of it.